An indigenous artist has recreated the TTC subway and bus route maps to include traditional landmarks and imagery. Posters are up at transit stations and art wrap streetcars are hitting the roads tonight. Yella Hadzik spoke to the artist behind the project. She joins us now. So let's start with what inspired this project, Yella.
Well, Dwight, Phil Cote has been an artist who has been at the forefront of trying to use his art to educate, to inspire, and especially to reimagine the narrative that has been told so long in our country. Now, June happens to be National Indigenous History Month. I'm going to give you a look at this TTC project. First of all, let's start with the streetcars, okay? Because there are five of them fully wrapped in his art. As you say, Dwight, this is a reimagined map. So instead of certain landmarks and certain bus or subway stations that you're used to seeing, they're going to be a little different. I'm going to give you a listen to Phil right now as I show you as well some posters that are going to be slapped all around town. This is various subway stations, on buses. You'll be seeing Phil Cote's artwork all throughout the transit system during the month of June. Here's what he had to say.
To see, you know, the names, the indigenous names of these three major rivers that went northward to Lake Simcoe. So Kvetchenung, Wisconsinash, and Chesapeake. They would see those names represented in the places of the Humber, the Don, and the Rouge. And each one of these rivers was very important in terms of how Toronto got its name. Toronto got its name because it was recognized as the carrying place, meaning it was a place of portage. And so the trade network that Indigenous people have been practicing for about 5,000 years now ran through these parts long before the Europeans arrived and long before there was fur trade.
And long before there was the TTC. So I had a chance to connect with that organization and just ask, you know, what was the inspiration for that? Shavlin Durrani is the head of communications, and she shared with me that the TTC is very serious about really living its values, that it's trying to be more representative of the city, of diversity, and this is what else she had to say.
I just love that we are showcasing these, you know, this really interesting artwork on our platform, which is huge, and that Torontonians can see it and hopefully talk about it and learn more, right? That's, I think, really one of our big goals around this too, is to create awareness and to help create conversation.
And you know, Dwight, just to mention Beta Christi, St. Clair West is Spadina, Florida Davisville, St. George and Leslie for track level. So it really is covering a huge swath of the city so that we can all enjoy Phil Cote's art.
You know, Yella, we have to talk about this because the project has been in the works for a long time, but it launches this week and it happens to coincide with a particularly painful time, as we all have been learning of the mass grave of the children's remains at the residential school in BC. So what did the artist say about his feelings at this particular time?
Yeah, I mean, Dwight, it's just heartbreaking. And I'm going to give you a little bit of a sense of his work, because the murals that he creates throughout the city of Toronto are very, very colorful. And so you might feel that they're very positive and optimistic. But of course, juxtapose that with what we're talking about now, what we're seeing in the news, so heavy, so, so deeply painful. And so it is interesting that at this particular time, I'm gonna talk about in a moment why the TTC posters are all in black and white. But first, have a listen to Phil Cote.
Art and imagery can heal the mind and heal our past memories of things like this, because those 215 children that were found in these graves around that residential school in BC, they represent what Canada was trying to do, which was to wipe out identity, wipe out language and culture of Indigenous people, and have them assimilate into Canadian culture without being recognized as the original people. So my work today, going across the city of Toronto, is the exact opposite.
And you know, he did add that he feels it's absolutely meant to be, that the TTC art is in that black and white format, which mimics the original TTC posters, because he says in the Anishinaabe tradition, the understanding of the beginning of the universe was all about lightness and darkness. So he's saying that they can both coexist and that ultimately he really does want to try to bring the light and the positivity to all of us through his art.